Hello and welcome to this webinar about the new features in the VSDX Export 2.0. Let's wait a couple of seconds until everyone is here. All right, let's begin. This webinar will be about the new features in the VSDX Export 2.0. We released it in January this year, I think. My name is Lukas. I'm a software developer here at WiWorks. I mainly work on the WiFiles for HTML product, and I also work for some related products, like, for example, the VSDX export. So what we're going to do today, this will be a very quick webinar, roughly about 50 minutes, I guess. I will very quickly tell you about what Microsoft Visio is and what the VSDX export is. So we are all on the same page. Then I'm going to show you what's new in the VSDX for 2.x. And then I'm going to show you a small programming example, how to use the new features. And afterwards, there will be a questions and answers section where you can ask me questions about the VSDX export, and I will try to answer them as good as I can. I'm starting a couple of polls now. If you want, you can fill them in during the webinar. Let's start. What's Microsoft Visio? I guess most of you already know, but I'm going to tell you still. Microsoft Visio is a diagram editor. You can create and edit diagrams like flowcharts, organization charts, floor plans, etc. And it allows to dynamically bind data to the shapes in the diagram. And it also supports some automatic layouts, and the file format is VSDX or VSSX for stencil files. I can quickly show you how Visio looks like. So simple editor where you can drag in shapes and you can connect these shapes. What's the VSDX export? The VSDX export is an add-on for WiFiles for HTML. It has to be purchased separately. It also requires a WiFiles for HTML license, of course. And if you're interested in the VSDX export, contact our sales team at sales@wiworks.com. And you can also evaluate a 60 days evaluation version through our customer center online. The VSDX export automatically converts WiFiles diagrams to Visio files. It produces very high quality Visio files, meaning that it preserves the logical graph structure. You can edit the diagrams afterwards if you want to. And you wouldn't recognize any differences to compared to if a human had created the diagrams. The item styles, so there's the styling of the nodes, the edges and labels, is usually converted automatically. So usually you don't have to do anything about it. But if you want to, you can customize anything. And for example, you can also load stencils from VCO stencil files. So what's new in the 2.x versions? Or version. The VSDX export 1.x had basically a single use case, and the use case was to create a fresh VSDX file from a single Wi-Fi diagram. And while it was possible to add additional Wi-Fi additional shapes and pages, it was not possible to add additional Wi-Fi diagrams. And we changed this in the 2.0 version, where we allowed to create VSDX files with multiple Wi-Fi diagrams and optionally on multiple VCO pages. And we also added the feature that you can load VSDX files as templates or add Wi-Fi diagrams to existing VSDX files. And for this, we added a new entry class, the VSDX.io. And this class has all the methods you need for these features. And now I'm going to show you how we can use the VSDX.io class to create a VSDX file from multiple Wi-Fi diagrams and to load to put them into a template. Take a quick sip. So what do you want to achieve? I've started with the multigraph demo from the VSDX package. And this demo basically, you can look at four different diagrams. And if you push the export button like I did just now, you get this diagram, and where you have two diagrams on each page. We have two pages, and we also added these nice gray frames with the diagram titles. I can show you the code for this demo quickly. This is mostly the demo like it is in the package, but I've slightly refactored it so it is a little more readable, but that shouldn't bother you too much. Okay, so how do we achieve this? The VSDX export works like this. First, we create a default package of an instance of VSDX.io with an basically empty VSDX package. Then we create a export configuration, set evaluate formulas to true. That allows us to use functions for when we create the gray frame. And they will then automatically be evaluated. We also add a master provider for the demo edges. And then we create an export graph component since we don't want the export to modify the graph component that is currently visible. We create a new component, copy the style defaults, and then we start iterating over the four diagrams. And on each second diagram, we create a new page with the page dimensions. And then we add the diagram. We calculate the dimensions of the diagram in VCO page coordinates and in inches. Some magic. then we create the frame. The frame is basically two shapes, one shape for the gray border and one shape for the text. And we assign the dimensions to it. So then we load the graph from our sample to the export graph component. And finally, we add the graph to the East.xio instance by calling add graph. We pass it the export graph component, we pass it our config, we pass it the current page, and we pass it the target bounds we calculated. And after we've added all four diagrams, we can serialize the package by calling write blob, and afterwards we can save this blob to a file system. Yeah, that's the demo how it is in the package, and now we're gonna try to instead of creating a easy package from scratch, we want to load a template. I can show you the template I've created. This is very basic. We have a title on the top, and we have these page numbers here on the multi pages. And afterwards, we want to load this template. So and add diagrams to it, so it will look like this in the end, where we have our title from the template and our diagrams that we programmatically added. How do we do this? This is pretty simple. We basically have to change like two or three lines only. First, instead of creating an empty package, we call the from blob method, which will load our template blob and parse it. So this VSTXIO instance has done a VSTX package instance that is the parse template. And then the only other thing we have to change is instead of creating new pages, we just retrieve the existing page from the template. And yeah, that's basically it. So far about the programming example. Basically was the webinar. Now you have the chance to ask me questions, and I'll try to answer them as good as I can. And yeah, if you want to, you can still fill in the polls I activated earlier. There's a question. Is it possible to attach user data to the VSTX shapes? Yes, that's definitely possible. You can either use the shape data processing step class. This one will basically copy the information that is in an YFiles items tag. So for example, inode point tag. And this will copy the tag basically to the shape data. And then you can see it in the shape data panel in VSTXIO. Alternatively, you can just manually edit the property section. That's how the shape data is called in Visio. Your own shape processing step if you want to. There's another question. My labels are too small when I print the VSDX file. Can I increase the font size only for the exported file? Yes, you can basically modify anything of the output as you like. And the labels are too small, you can just adjust the font size on the way out, and then you will have larger labels. Okay, there's another question. Can there be different backgrounds per Visio page? What exactly do you mean by background? If you mean background pages, the background pages feature of Visio, then no, we haven't implemented this feature yet. Okay, background pages. Currently no, but you can of course add shapes to the background of the foreground page. That's possible, and then you can have different backgrounds on different pages. Okay, and a related question, what features will you add in the future? This basically depends on the user demand and on what our customers require. And if we then think that we can implement this and with reasonable effort, then we will try to implement it. And that we might add background pages in the future, but no guarantees here. All right, then if there are no further questions, this is the end of this webinar. Thanks for tuning in. Have a nice day and happy diagramming.